Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Vue Pivot Table component. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how to add the Vue Pivot Table component to a Vue application and how to bind items to the component from a data source. You will also see some of its key features like formatting, filtering, field list, and grouping bar. Let me start with the application creation process. I'm going to create a Vue application using the Vue Vite command. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Vue and Node.js. I edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output on a supported browser. To create a project in Vue, I open Visual Studio Code and type the command npm create vite at latest. Then I provide the app name, my Vue app. Here, I choose the framework as Vue and the variant as JavaScript. Now the Vue project is created. I navigate to the newly created Vue app and install the required dependencies using the npm install command. Now the application is configured with the default settings of a Vite project. To add the Syncfusion Vue Pivot Table component, install the Syncfusion Vue Pivot Vue package using the command npm install at syncfusion /ej2vue-pivot-vue --save. This command will install the Vue Pivot Vue package along with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, the application is ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. So, I open the main.js file and import the register license method. From the Syncfusion EJ2 base package, using this method, I register the trial license key. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, it is required to register the Vue license key. To know how to generate this license key, refer to the link attached in the description below. Now, I will start to add the pivot table component. So let me open the app.vue file and remove the default code. Then, import the pivot view component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Pivot Vue package. And register them globally inside the component's property with all its child directives. Then add the component by adding the EJS Pivot View tag inside the template section. Now, I need to bind data to the pivot table. To do that, I define a function called data. This function will return an object named DataSourceSettings. To this DataSourceSettings object, I will add a list, DataSource, which contains amount, country, date, product, quantity, and state fields. I also set values to the height and width of the pivot table inside this data function. Now, I am going to assign this height and width to the pivot table using the height and width properties. Then, I assign the data source list to the pivot table using the data source settings property. To apply styles to the pivot table component, I import the Bootstrap theme styles to the style section. Let's save the changes and run the application using the command npm run dev. The pivot table is rendered with no data.
This is because the rows, columns, and their aggregation values are not defined.
To display the pivot table with the defined data source, I need to add three major axes: pivot view rows, pivot view columns, and pivot view values. Pivot view rows are the collection of fields that need to be displayed on the row axis. Pivot view columns are the collection of fields that need to be displayed on the column axis. And pivot view values are the collection of fields that have aggregated numeric values. Now, let's see how to add these axes to the pivot table. Inside the data source settings property, I define the rows property. This property will accept n number of rows in it. As of now, I will add two fields, country and product, to it by setting the appropriate field's name to the name property. Similarly, I want to add the date field to the columns by adding the columns property
and setting the name to date.
Then I add the fields amount and quantity to the value axis by defining the values property and setting the appropriate values to the name property. You can see now that the pivot table is rendered with the defined data source and has the country and product fields in rows, the date field in columns, and the amount and quantity fields in values. Look at the values. The default summary type is sum. To change the summary type, I can use the type property. The Syncfusion pivot table supports a maximum of 22 summary types. Now, I will show you how to display the pivot table values with the maximum summary type. To do that, I set the type property to max in the quantity field. Now, the summary type is maximum in the quantity field. Next, let's see how to do formatting. The formatting feature allows you to display the values in desired formats. The Syncfusion pivot table supports both standard format and custom format for the value axes. Now, I will show you how to set the currency format for the amount field. For that, I define the format settings property. As I am going to set the format to the amount field, I set the name property to amount and the format to C1. Now, the amount field is displayed in the currency format. Next, I will show you how to perform interactions like adding, removing, rearranging the fields, filtering, and sorting on the pivot table component. I can use the field list property to achieve all these interactions dynamically in runtime. The Syncfusion pivot table supports two types of field lists, namely, inbuilt and standalone. In this example, I am going to show you the inbuilt field list by importing the field list property in the import section. Then, I define a variable, showFieldList, inside the data function and set its value to true. To make the FieldList option available for all components in the Vue.js application, I define the provide option and inject it. Next, I need to assign this value to the pivot table component using the showFieldList property. Look here, this is the field list icon. And when I click on it, a dialog box opens. Here, I can do all interactions on the pivot table. First, I sort. Then, I remove the field product from the table. Looking at the component now, the product field is removed. Suppose I want to add the product field again, then I can simply check the product field option in the dialog. Look here, the pivot table is updated with the product field. Next, let me show you how to filter. I click the filter icon of the country field. Here I can either search for the item to be filtered in the text box or uncheck it from the list. Here I have unchecked Sweden from the list. Looking at the pivot table now, Sweden is removed from the country field. Okay, let's see how to enable the grouping bar in the pivot table component. Grouping bar automatically populates fields from the data source and display as bars in the pivot table component. It allows to drag data source fields between different axes and provides options to sort, filter, and remove the axes dynamically in runtime. To enable the grouping bar feature in the pivot table, I import the grouping bar property in the import section. Then, I define a variable showGroupingBar inside the data function
and set its value to true. I also inject the grouping bar property in the provide option to make it available for all the components. Finally, I assign this grouping bar value to the component using the showGroupingBar property. See now, the component is rendered with grouping bars and the data source fields are displayed as bars. Using these bars, I can perform interactions like sorting, filtering, removing fields, dragging and dropping fields between axes. I can also change the summary type of the value fields here. Finally, let's see about pivot view filters. Apart from the rows, columns, and values axis, there is one more axis called the pivot view filter axis. You can add fields to the pivot view filter axis either by adding them using the filters property, or by dragging and dropping them to the axis at runtime. This axis filters the row, column, and value fields in the pivot table. It also filters the records based on the fields that are not bound to the pivot table data source. For instance, I would like to display only the country field in the rows. But I want to filter records based on the product field. In such a case, I can remove the product field from the rows property and add it to the filter axis using the filters property. This property accepts any number of filters within it. Now, I will add the product field by setting the name property to product. Check now, the product field is removed from the row axis and added to the filter axis. I can filter the records based on product, even though it's not bound to the table. I click the filter icon, uncheck the car from the list. Looking at the pivot table now, the amount and quantity fields have only the values of the bike. In this video, you have seen how to create a Vue app and add the Syncfusion pivot table component to it. You have also seen how to bind data to the pivot table from a data source and some of its important features like formatting, field list, filtering, and grouping bar. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link given in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Vue products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.